Welcome to Digital Yarbs, where real faces spring to life from the very essence of life masks.
Born into French aristocracy in 1757, the Marquis de Lafayette swiftly ascended the military hierarchy. Commissioned as a sub-lieutenant at the age of 13, he achieved the rank of lieutenant by 16. Driven by a fervent desire to support the American cause, Lafayette enlisted as a major general in the Continental Army in 1776. Although initial plans were thwarted, he eventually arrived in America in June 1777. Forging a close bond with General Washington, Lafayette played a pivotal role in the Battle of Brandywine, demonstrating resilience by leading a division after recovering from a leg wound. His strategic brilliance shone in the Battle of Barren Hill, marking a significant achievement. After mustering additional troops in France, he returned in 1780, leading a division crucial to the British surrender at Yorktown in 1781. Upon his return to France, Lafayette's opposition to radicals during the French Revolution led to a decline in his standing. In 1824, he revisited the United States and was celebrated as a hero before passing away in France in 1834. 2 months after the pivotal Battle of Yorktown in December 1781, the Virginia legislature unanimously resolved to commission a bust of the Marquis de Lafayette. However, the project was forgotten until Lafayette mentioned it to George Washington in September 1783. Thomas Jefferson and the American consul at Nantes selected the renowned artist Jean-Antoine Houdon for the task. Known for his meticulous technique, Houdon had crafted life masks and busts of prominent figures like Washington, Voltaire, Rousseau, and Benjamin Franklin. At the age of 28, Lafayette's first life mask by Houdon was created in July 1785. Houdon meticulously captured the bone structure of Lafayette's face, including the high sloping forehead, arched eyebrows, prominent cheekbones, and straight, fine nose. The skin was portrayed as smooth and unlined, while the artist added plaster to fill in the bald form at the back of the head and to indicate the pleats of a cravat at the neck. This life mask encapsulates Lafayette's dreamy, idealistic character and aristocratic refinement. Houdon subsequently produced several busts from this life mask, with one presented to the city of Paris on behalf of the Commonwealth of Virginia and another sent to the Capitol building in Richmond, Virginia. The second life mask of Lafayette was created by John Henry Isaac Browere, an American sculptor renowned for his life masks of notable figures such as John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, and James Madison. During Lafayette's final visit to America, he faced numerous requests from artists seeking to capture his likeness for portraits. Among those he agreed to sit for was Browere. Browere met Lafayette on Monday, July 18th, in the Hall of Independence, Philadelphia. On Tuesday morning, from 7 to 8 o'clock, Browere diligently crafted another likeness from Lafayette's face and head. By 4 p.m. that day, he completed the bust under the watchful eyes of Lafayette and his attendant. Lafayette expressed satisfaction, affirming that it was the only good bust ever made of him. This sentiment was shared by others. Browere sought testimonies from prominent Americans, including Samuel Morse and Rembrandt Peale, both of whom had painted Lafayette, attesting to the accuracy of his life mask. Lafayette's life mask was a likeness so admirable and of such remarkable fidelity that General Jacob Morton, Rembrandt Peale, DeWitt Clinton, Samuel Morse, John Graham, Thomas Addis Emmett, and others came forward and enthusiastically bore witness to its being a perfect facsimile of the distinguished Frenchman. Rembrandt Peale, widely known by his portrait of George Washington, wrote, "The singular excellence shown by Mr. Browere in his new method of executing portrait busts from the life deserves the applause and patronage of his countrymen. The bust of Lafayette, which he has just finished, is an admirable demonstration of his talent in this department of the fine arts. The accuracy with which he has molded the entire head, neck, and shoulders from the life and his skill in finishing render this bust greatly superior to any we have seen. It is in truth a faithful and a living likeness. Of this I may judge, having twice painted the general's portrait from the life, once at Paris and recently at Washington." Portrait painter Samuel Finley Breeze Morse wrote, being requested by Mr. Browere to give my opinion of his bust or cast from the person of General Lafayette, I feel no hesitation in saying it appears to me to be a perfect facsimile of the general's face. Now, witness the facial reconstructions from both Houdon's and Browere's life masks of Lafayette, alongside contemporary interpretations.